I'm a community organizer. I'm not a technology person. I've always been interested in ways to communicate with people, whether that was door-to-door, person-to-person, or news media. In the 70s, I became very interested in news media communication, television, and radio. As the internet became available in the 90s, I was interested in it as a communication device for community organizing. But it wasn't clear to me how effective it could be in organizing around gender issues. So it wasn't until later in 2008, 9, or 10 that I began to try to do communication through internet technology as a means of community organizing. I should say that there are many people, including Elena and Toxic Lesbian, who have been much more experimental in this area and have taught me things. In fact, in 2010, when we all worked together at Arena Sofia, Elena was very instrumental in creating a portion of our projects that was communicated through web technology. So that is really the invention, in that case, of Toxic Lesbian, not myself. However, since I was inspired by those works and by much of the organizing that had been going on throughout the Middle East with different kinds of electronic media in the service of local revolutions, I decided during 3 weeks in January to include the communications technologies of the web along with more traditional communication forms, for example, television, radio, newsprint, and so on. I started with a question about whether in organizing women around the subject of violence, and particularly rape in Los Angeles, person-to-person organizing, person-to-organization organizing, or online organizing. And one of the questions I had was, you know, in the 70s, the awareness of violence against women came from small consciousness-raising groups. Groups of 7-10 women would get together and they would talk about personal experience. And during that experience, they would begin to reveal secrets of what they had experienced through sexual violence. And those were very intimate groups, and they were formed through relationships, and people's secrecy was maintained through relationships. And there was a physical embodiment of the experience and people listening to the experience. That is, these groups were small and you could comfort each other, you could hold each other, you could cry. There was a really direct embodied experience as rape became revealed to the larger culture through consciousness raising and small feminist groups. Slowly, that experience was communicated through media, through television, through print media, through books, through articles, and through speeches. All of these were more traditional forms of communication. Now you come to 2010, and the extreme prevalence of communication by this generation through web technologies, which includes Instagrams and Twitter and Facebook and so on. And the question I had was whether or not the embodiment of the original revelations of rape would carry through to the disembodiment of the web culture. And would internet provide a welcome ability for women to remain private while revealing personal issues, or would it allow for more, for less, actually less human contact and less comforting? And ultimately, would there be more or less political analysis through the revelation of the private experience? So that was the question. I know that the forms of community organizing now in this generation are very web-based and, you know, very media technology-based, so that I've noticed my students, for example, believe that if they send an email to somebody, that email will be answered. And they presume that people get an email and respond to an email. I would, in my organizing, would never make that presumption. I would need a confirmation back. So there are very different forms of organizing, and in 3 weeks in January, we decided to try both person-to-person organizing of 50 organizations, and we tried online organizing of larger numbers of people, just people that were not necessarily connected to organizations.
So Elena is asking you if you are you're talking about these communities that are around the two pieces, I mean, the one at Brooklyn and the other one at LA. So you had another relationship with these communities because of the web?
Okay, well, let me explain in the example of 3 weeks in January. We decided to do an online component that started as a device to see how many people had been raped or experienced rape, or to invite those women to share experience. And so through Facebook and Twitter, we developed a campaign. And rather than create the campaign around "Have you been raped?", we decided that it would be better to displace the violence onto a possible other person by creating a campaign that said, "I know someone who's been raped, do you?" So our campaign was, "I know someone, do you?" And we created tags, and we created a web presence and a Twitter presence of "I know someone, do you?", which would invite people into the conversation without having to reveal the fact that they themselves had been raped. Maybe they had, maybe they hadn't, but that would be their decision. And so that was the idea of that part of the project, to create an online organizing, "I know someone, do you," using that tag phrase, and to create an offline organizing with people communicating directly, calling, emailing, and inviting organizations to come to specific events or to offer specific events. So I can't tell you much about the online community, because all I know about it is what occurred, you know, in either Twitter or Facebook conversations. And I don't know anything more about them except online and in direct communication. Many women had experienced violence against women. But that community was not particularly available to me, because it was not a discursive environment, if that makes sense to you.
So even when you work with this community, you work with some community managers. So Elena is imagining that you might have a lot of previous meeting with the community managers, because these community managers get in a style that they already used. So in a way, Elena thinks that if the question is if they were kind of the communicators between yourself and the community.
Yes, and I see where she's going with that. There is, in particularly between the door and the street, which was not, we did not use electronic or online communications as an aspect of the work, as we did in 3 weeks in January. We only used it to advertise and communicate, but it wasn't centralized in the way Elena's work is, or in the way we did it 3 weeks in January, which is that it was an element of the project. And so in the project between the door and the street, there was a lot of mediation between me and the actual performers by various organizations and organizers. So I would communicate with a group of 10 organizers who would each go out and communicate with 10 organizations. And so in a sense, my communication with the performers was mediated through people, just like in 3 weeks in January, my communication between people involved in the project was mediated technologically. Is that what she's suggesting?